Top 10 terrible deaths connected to social media. Social media is incredibly divisive. Most people agree that it's marvelous at connecting us, but there's a strong movement towards reducing the time we spend online. The coronavirus quarantines and social distancing guidelines are an exception, of course. The internet can definitely have an unfavorable impact on some aspects of our lives, making us unhappy occasionally. However, the negative repercussions of social media can also be grave enough to be linked to fatalities. 10. Influencers birthday pool party drownings. Earlier this year, the death of three Russians at a birthday pool party was announced on Instagram, creating a frenzy on the internet. The beginning of the story does not sound that unusual, until you realize that about 25 kilograms, 55 pounds, of dry ice were dumped into the pool. In the aftermath of the tragedy, Yekaterina Didenko, the birthday girl and influencer, tearfully recounted the devastating event to her over 1 million followers. Russian news media and some bloggers criticized her for trying to capitalize on it. 9. Choking challenge, the internet's most dangerous craze. The choking game, aka fainting game, is the act of intentionally cutting off oxygen to the brain, causing the person to pass out. Children and teenagers take the challenge mostly due to curiosity. Allegedly, it induces euphoria and peer pressure. This incredibly dangerous and irresponsible activity has been around since long before the internet existed. In fact, the first death was reported in 1995. Even though the internet cannot be blamed for the creation of the choking game, it can be credited for its resurgence. Social media viral challenges are a huge deal for young people. Usually, when a teenager sees someone his age doing something thrilling on the internet, he'll try to replicate it. That's the purpose of these challenges, which range from the ridiculous to the horrifying. 8. Deadliest selfies, part 1. Model falls off a cliff. People will do anything for a selfie. If you don't believe that, just do a quick search on selfie-related deaths. Madeline Davis was not the first and won't be the last casualty caused by the search for a great picture. Davis, a makeup artist and social media influencer, was an expert in eyelash styling and had thousands of followers across different platforms. She was vacationing in Australia when the tragedy occurred. Davis fell off a cliff in Diamond Bay Reserve in Sydney while trying to take a risky photo. Police and paramedics launched an air and water search with the assistance of the Marine Area Command. Unfortunately, the body of the British model was found in the water about 4 hours later. She had died on impact from head injuries. 7. Facebook unfriending culminates in a double homicide. Have you ever been unfriended on Facebook? It's not a nice feeling. But normal people get over it in a couple of hours. 31-year-old Jenna Potter did not have a typical reaction. Instead, she decided that murder was the sensible response. This story deserves a list of its own as it involves jealousy, the CIA, and a double homicide. Here's the short version. After allegedly being cyberbullied by a couple of her former friends, Jenna convinced her parents to shoot them. The crime happened in 2012. Janelle's father claimed that he acted according to his own impulses. However, the prosecutor of the case believed that Janelle had manipulated her parents with a catfishing scheme. Allegedly, Janelle used social media to deceive her parents into killing her former friends. She created a fake profile of a CIA agent. The agent sent messages saying that Janelle's life was in danger. 6. Woman lynched by a mob in Brazil over an internet rumor. Spreading rumors is a nasty thing to do. Although the practice was not invented online, it has certainly been exacerbated by the internet. In the old days, the impact of a rumor was limited to small groups of people. Usually, the worst-case scenario was getting a raunchy reputation in your school. However, rumors gain a whole new dimension with the internet's reach and propensity to distort reality. In 2014, Fabienne Maria de Jesus, a mother of two, was identified by a local Facebook page as a criminal accused of kidnapping children and sacrificing them in satanic rituals. The origin of the misunderstanding was supposedly a police sketch that vaguely resembled a picture of her. 5. teenager is cyberbullied until he commits suicide. The earliest deaths attributed to the internet are related to cyberbullying-induced suicide, which is made much worse by social media. As a society, we now take bullying more seriously due to the long-lasting effects on the victims. It can be difficult to put an end to bullying in schools, but it is even harder to stop it on the internet. One of the most notorious cases is the suicide of 13-year-old Ryan Halligan. He was relentlessly cyberbullied by other kids on MySpace due to a rumor that he was gay. At one point, a girl pretended to like him, only to later publicly humiliate the boy for believing in her affection. Ryan told her, "It is girls like you that make me want to kill myself." Ryan hanged himself in 2003. His lifeless body was found by his sister. 4. Deadliest Selfies Part 2 Mauled by a Bear. In another selfie-related incident, a man was killed by a bear in India while trying to take a picture with the animal. After attending a wedding, Prabhu Bhattara was driving back to his house when he decided to stop to urinate in the woods. While doing so, he spotted an injured bear, which prompted him to attempt to take the selfie of the year. As Prabhu approached the animal, the bear attacked and a struggle ensued. A stray dog at the site intervened but failed to deter the bear. The whole ordeal was filmed by a bystander, and clips of the horrific incident can be found on the internet. 7. India's wildlife often clashes with people in the suburban areas of the country. To no one's surprise, that was the third fatality linked to selfies with wild animals in that region in a year. 3. YouTuber dies in a paragliding accident while filming a YouTube video. Having a YouTube channel drives you to do crazy things to get views. On the King of Random channel, Grant Thompson used to showcase DIY projects and experiments, but outdoor activities were also featured. Unfortunately, the influencer passed away in 2019. He was found dead near Sand Hollow State Park, Utah. Along with his body, paragliding equipment and a recording device were recovered. This suggested that he died while attempting to film a video for his popular YouTube channel. 2. Woman strangled by her Tinder date in a rough sex session. Tinder is probably the first name that pops into your mind when you think of online dating. The platform is so successful that even non-users understand what the terms swipe left and swipe right mean. Dating in the social media era can make you feel safer. You don't meet people face to face right away, and you can get a friend to track your position through GPS. However, this extra sense of security can lead you to ignore basic instincts and bypass self-preservation precautions. Women are especially vulnerable to predatory behavior. The death of 22-year-old Grace Millane serves as an example of how we can never be too safe while meeting people we don't know. While the British woman was backpacking in New Zealand, she agreed to go on a date with a man she met on Tinder. The date went from promising to tragic when she was strangled during a rough sex session. The man, not identified for legal reasons, hid her remains in a suitcase. Then he went on another date with another woman. 1. Lips to Die For The Kylie Jenner Challenge. Kylie Jenner is a media personality who stars in the reality TV show Keeping Up With The Kardashians. Her estimated net worth is $1 billion, making her the youngest billionaire at 21. She is known for her ravishing beauty, of which the most coveted aspect is definitely her plump lips. The desire to have Kylie's pouty lips inspired the Kylie Jenner Lip Challenge. Teenagers inserted their lips into shot glasses and sucked out the air to create a vacuum. The aim was to swell the lips. The problem is that the act itself is dangerous due to the injuries sustained to the face. In 2015, a story circulated online that Natalie Cardenas, 19, was found dead on her bedroom floor with huge lips and a shot glass in her hands. According to the fictional account, the tragedy prompted the authorities to declare the Kylie Jenner Lip Challenge illegal in the United States. Although no credible source confirms that story, it's a good idea to skip the challenge as it can cause real and possibly lasting injuries.